I have a new video for you guys because we are talking about the feud of the century. Britney Spears and Christina Aguilera are two of music's biggest pop stars. These ladies dominated the early 2000s, and they were often pinned against each other. So was this feud legit, or was this a media firestorm created by the tabloids? Today, we are talking about the history of Britney Spears and Christina Aguilera. We're going to talk about their friendship, their fights, their career, and their current stance. So let's get into it. Before we get into this video, here is a quick message from our sponsor. Scentbird is a fragrance subscription service that you can use to shop from over 600 brands. And what's fun about Scentbird is it lets you choose a designer fragrance to try every month for just $16. I actually picked out this cologne, Get a Room, which smells so good, and I love the green container. Oh, it's my favorite scent right now. And what's cool about Scentbird is they send you these little cards to explain the fragrances. And this one, for example, says, "All heat, plenty of skin. This scent layers mandarin, smooth woods, liquid vanilla, sage oil, and a bite of forbidden apple." And I love it. But what's great about Scentbird is that you get to pick your fragrances every month, so there are no surprises. They have colognes, they have perfumes, they have a bunch of options, and they have unisex options as well. With each fragrance, you will get a 30-day supply, and pretty much the scent comes up this way in the vial, and you can actually pull it out, and you guys can see you get a good amount. And I've actually been using this for about a week now. I love this scent. I'm a little biased because it's Versace Eros, which is bougie, and it's great because Scentbird has a bunch of designer brands, and they also have indie brands, so some scents you probably never heard of. So I recommend trying it out. There are so many high-end fragrances on this website, and if you end up liking a scent, you could just buy a full bottle. But if not, you can go and get a subscription, try different fragrances every single month, and if you use my code, you will only spend $11 for your first month of Scentbird. So use my code SLOAN30 for 30% off your first order from Scentbird. You can also check out more scents from Scentbird on their Instagram, their website, or try their new app on your iPhone or Android. So thank you, Scentbird, for sponsoring this video, and happy shopping. A ton of you guys have been asking for this video because we have been covering Britney Spears on my channel for some time. As you guys know, she has been trapped in a conservatorship for 13 years now. But before that conservatorship started, she had quite a life. Britney was one of music's most successful pop stars ever, and during her career, she had some ups and downs. And one of those ups and downs involved Christina Aguilera, because they knew each other for a long time. They were supposedly really close friends at some point. I mean, watch this clip of Christina talking about her relationship with Britney.
Okay, give me a line on Britney. What do you remember of her most as?
We would all play ping pong in the back, and I don't know, we had a lot of fun together. A lot of fun. Me and Brit, best friends. I miss her.
In 1999, Christina may have considered Britney her bestie then, but that definitely did not last for long, because they went downhill as the early 2000s came about. But before we get into that, let's talk about the beginning of their friendship and their relationship, because back in 1993, they were both stars on the Mickey Mouse Club. This was a television show that was very popular in the 90s, and there were big stars on it, including Justin Timberlake, Ryan Gosling, and then Christina Aguilera was added last. She was the last of four to join those megastars. Christina and Britney instantly clicked. They had such a close relationship while on that show because they were around the same age. Both girls also supposedly started having crushes on Justin Timberlake at that time. And that's when some say their feud actually began, because they were fighting over JT. But I think it starts a little bit later in their friendship. And by friendship, I mean a real friendship, because they definitely did like each other while on the show, and when it canceled, they were both so heartbroken.
I remember Britney and Christina, they were always inseparable. You know, wherever you wanted to find one, look for the other one.
But that happiness was short-lived. After just over a season, the show was canceled.
There's a picture floating around. It was me and Brittany were crying like so hard on one of the other Mouseketeers' shoulders.
So these girls were crying on one of their fellow castmates because they were so upset that the show was canceled. I'm not too sure why it was canceled because it seemed to be quite successful, but they canceled it and they had to go back home. This was in the year of 1993. This was a huge transition for the girls because they were used to working on that show, working really long hours, hanging out with their friends all day, and Christina and Brittany grew quite close. But after the show was canceled, they did go back home. They started to live kind of normal lives. I mean, they were still in the entertainment industry, but nothing really happened until 1998. Brittany just signed to Jive Records, which is a pretty big record label, and they helped her release her song, Baby One More Time, which was a huge success. It was her first single, and everyone was shook because it was so great and it did so well on the charts. That same year, Christina was actually signed to another record label titled RCA. And pretty much RCA wanted their own version of Britney Spears because at this point, Britney was preparing to release her album. She put out her singles. The public was loving her. They loved this young girl, kind of like innocent, but also acting a little bit provocative, and they wanted to have their own version of it. At the beginning of Christina's career, it was extremely controlled because, again, the record label wanted to mimic what was going on with Britney. So when it came to how Christina looked, how she sounded, her songs, she had zero control because they were pretty much mimicking what Britney did. Then comes 1999, and in January, Britney releases her album, Baby One More Time, and it does amazing. Christina released her first album later that year. It was self-titled, and it was put out in August. It was similar to Britney Spears' music in a way because they had that bubblegum pop sound, but Christina, you guys know, has an incredible voice, so it was a little bit more R&B so that she can show off her vocals. Christina was definitely doing well in the music scene, but she was never doing as well as Britney, and there are several reasons why, because I think Britney Spears won over America because of her music, but also because of her personality. She was that Midwestern, innocent girl who was just kind of quirky and sweet, and Christina was starting to become this bad girl. So she looked a little bit more edgy, she was a little bit more provocative, and that was just her style. And even though they had these clear distinctions between the two, the public could not help but compare and pin them against each other. Here's one of Christina's friends actually sharing their thoughts on what Christina must have been going through at this time, because even though her music was doing well, it was definitely not as great as Britney's, and every single time she did an interview, she was asked about Britney Spears.
The first thing that I ever thought about Christina was I felt sorry for her. Because you couldn't read an article about her without seeing Britney Spears.
I'm an 18-year-old girl, you know what I mean? Of course I'm gonna have similarities to other young people out there.
As different as Christina was from Britney, the media just wouldn't let it go. But Christina had a really big win at this time in her life, because the 42nd Grammys actually came around, and both of the artists were nominated for Best New Artist. But Christina actually won, and it was a huge moment in her career, because at this point, she hadn't even had her album out yet. She just had some singles, and the Grammys loved it.
Christina Aguilera!
Oh my god, you guys.
Even though Britney's sales numbers were far superior, the Grammys saw something in Christina and they awarded her that award. So, you know, congrats Christina, even though a lot of Britney fans think that Britney was robbed of it. Around this time, Britney was super busy because she actually started opening up on tour with NSYNC. They were on their tour titled NSYNC in Concert, and between June 1998 and January 2000, Britney was opening up for NSYNC in Concert, and this started a bunch of rumors between Justin and Britney, and that's actually when it was rumored that these two were together. They did start dating during this tour, and they became the It Couple, which honestly helped Britney's career grow even bigger. In my opinion, I feel like Justin also kind of used Britney to help grow his career, and I actually talk about that in a video about Justin Timberlake, so definitely go check that out if you have not seen it before. As for Christina, she could not stop the media from comparing her to Britney. I mean, seriously, the year of 2000 must have been so annoying for her because every single interview I watched of her, she was being asked about Britney.
There's no rivalry between me and Britney Spears. We're good, but there's no competition at all. You know, if I'm in competition with anybody, it's with myself. She's a cool girl, no fighting, but we are two very different artists.
Honestly, I sympathize with Christina on this because it must be so frustrating to show up to an interview and to be constantly asked about Britney. Because at one point, you know, in the past, they were friends, early in the 90s. They were close. And you guys remember in the beginning of this video, Christina actually called Britney her bestie at one point.
Me and Brit, best friends. I miss her.
Now we're in the year 2000, their careers have picked up a ton, and Christina just cannot stop the media from asking her about Britney.
Yeah, totally, and it's always cool to see Britney.
Yeah.
But we're two completely different artists, that's the thing, and yeah. I think, you know, time will only prove that, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And even more so, more often, I think the comparisons are stopping.
I think it's the blonde hair, because I'm always getting compared to Britney Spears as well.
So, I mean, there's no jealousy going on,
There's no need for jealousy, no. You know, we're musicians and we're out there making music, doing what we love to do, and there should be no rivalry about that, and we're just two completely different things, and regardless of similarities and maybe age or background or whatnot.
While the ladies do all of this press to promote their music and their careers, the media continues to form their personas, and there's actually an article from Cosmo in 2018, where pretty much Christina says, it's hard to hear yourself being called names. She says, I remember being hurt by these commercials on MTV, pitting Britney as the good girl and me as the bad girl. It's like, if I'm going to be demure and innocent, that's okay. But if I'm going to be just myself, I'm trouble. She starts telling stories of music execs treating her badly. There were male reps who never left the room when she did clothing fittings. Ew, what are you talking about? And someone supposedly called her difficult one day because she was exhausted and yawned during a meeting. Oh god, that must be so frustrating. I mean, the execs in Hollywood are just savages in the worst way possible. She finally shared a story about some guys who sat at dinner with her, supposedly talking crudely about other women's bodies, as if Christina just wasn't there. So this was a weird time for Christina because she could not escape the Britney questions. She, at the same time, was being portrayed as this bad girl, and she really didn't know how to accept that. It also doesn't help when someone constantly tells you that you are a reminder of another pop star who you have been friends with, have been competing with, and now is compared to every single day.
The weirdest thing is just how, you know, there's been a lot of press within the last year comparing all of us and putting like rivalry between me and other artists, and it's just so untrue and so ridiculous, and it's such competition or rivalry between artists out there, and we're all different things, and it's just a matter of time before everyone totally sees it. And listen to the record, you know, you'll hear that you see the difference in the lash. I mean, it's all different, so.
Then on May 3rd, 2000, Britney releases her album, Oops, I Did It Again, which was a huge smashing hit for her. Later that year, Christina actually released her second album as well, titled Mi Reflejo? Reflejo? I think it means My Reflection in Spanish. I'm sorry for my pronunciation. Anyways, she released that on September 12th, 2000, and it was a fully Spanish album. At this point in Christina's career, she was so frustrated. She did not like her manager, Steve, and she actually fired the dude, which she really didn't have the power to do, because when you are signed to a record label like she was to RCA, she has no authority over her craft, her creative direction, nor her managers. So she was tired of Steve. She didn't like him controlling her music, her look, her sound, everything and above. So she fires him, and she actually ends up suing him. This turns into a huge legal battle for Christina, and at the end of the day, RCA actually decides to just give her a new manager manager and let her do what she wants. This was great for Christina because she was finally able to do what she wants. And in March 2001, she released smashing hit Lady Marmalade, and this was huge for Christina. It did very well, and she seemed very happy with it. I believe this was a shift in Christina's career and her persona, and probably getting rid of that old manager was a good move. Britney was also doing very well in 2001. She was the face of Pepsi, which was iconic. She also released her third album, which was self-titled Britney. This came out October 31st, 2001, and it included songs like Slave for You, and you guys all know about the VMA performance with her snake. That was one of the highlights in Britney's career. Even though Britney was getting a little more hot on stage, she was still keeping her very innocent persona. She wanted to wait until marriage. She wanted to keep herself pure. And I think the media loved this because she was kind of like the good girl who was kind of acting bad, but at the same time, she was just a Midwestern Louisiana girl just dating Justin Timberlake, even though Justin Timberlake was always hinting that he was doing stuff with Britney behind the scenes.
I'd like to think that at first, he'll date a popular female singer. Publicly, they'll claim to be friends, but privately, he hid it.
The Britney and Christina comparison from 2000 went into 2001, and there are several interviews where you can see Christina is visibly annoyed that she still has to be talking about this situation.
There's always that comparison thing, which is really old by now. I'm just bored with the topic now. It's just something that comes with the territory, and she's doing her thing, I'm doing mine, and it's two very different commercials.
That's what people talk about, you versus Britney and Madonna. Tell me about that.
I mean, there'll always be competition, and everybody works so hard in this business that, you know, I think everybody deserves an award.
Now we're in the year 2002. Crossroads, a movie by Britney Spears, was released, and honestly, the critics gave it a pretty bad review, but I remember watching it as a little kid, and I would have given it a 10 out of 10. Honestly, I want to go back and watch it again. That movie was released in February, and later that year, in September, Christina actually released her song, Dirty. The music video, the images, the whole vibe of the song definitely solidified her as the bad girl in pop music. Britney still had that good girl vibe, even with her Slave for You song and performance. It's kind of like Christina took Slave for You and then just made it so much more edgy with her song Dirty. During some time in 2002, Britney's album, titled Britney, became a number one hit, and it was actually her third consecutive album to reach number one. So her music was doing great, and Christina's was doing well, but it was never selling like Britney's. But later that year, in 2002, October, she released her album, Stripped, which had some of Christina's most iconic songs like Beautiful and Stronger. And honestly, that song, Beautiful, will like forever live with me. It's like an anthem you listen to when you're so depressed and sad, and you're like, I am beautiful. Thank you, Christina.
You are beautiful, no matter what they say.
So with her latest album released, Christina was on the up and up, but Britney was kind of going through it because her relationship with Justin Timberlake was going downhill. This was because Justin was trying to suggest that Britney cheated on him, which honestly, we talked about this in my Justin Timberlake video. I believe that Justin cheated first because Britney's sister literally came out and told us that Justin cheated first. But if you want to know more about that, definitely go watch that video. But the breakup begins and it bleeds into 2003. And honestly, 2003 is when their feud really starts to pick up because Christina does some very shady things. First off, right when Britney and Justin break up, Christina actually does a joint tour with Justin because they both are releasing albums. Like I said, Christina just released her album Stripped, and Justin was coming out with his album Justified, so they decided to do a joint tour titled The Justified and Stripped Tour, which I feel like is a big F you to Britney. I mean, she just got into a breakup with Justin, and Christina is pretty much her, like, media enemy, so both of them going on tour together is just a big power move. This tour actually fuels rumors that Christina and Justin are a couple, but those are rumors that they have both denied throughout the years. Christina actually did an interview with Rolling Stone at this time to promote their tour, and one of the questions the interviewer asked to Christina was, who do you think is Justin's ideal mate? And Christina replied, Britney. He and Britney made a great couple. I've known both of them since that time, and they just kind of had their little crushes even back then. Britney has known him for such a long time, too. Before he was Justin Timberlake, when he was just Justin, the kid on the Mickey Mouse Club. I don't know, I just have a feeling there's going to be some reconciliation. I know that they talk and everything, and it's cool. I don't think that it's over. I definitely don't think that Justin liked that Christina went and spoke on his relationship with Britney, because later on, there was another interview where they asked about this interview, and watch how annoyed Justin was.
I think Justin should get back with Britney in your Rolling Stone interview you guys just did. Did you say that, and if so, why?
In the interview, they asked, who out there could you see Justin most likely to be with? Mm-hmm. And, you know, I just see a lot of girls around him, and he knows this, that are just so out to be with him for him and the whole thing. And it's just like, cut it, give me a break. Ooh, I used your word. And, you know, it's just like, whatever. And I just know that Britney has known him since she was a little girl, before he was like Justin the star, and he was just Justin. But I don't want to make somebody uncomfortable, so we'll just drop that subject.
It's a little too late for that, isn't it?
Oh,
I'm
sorry.
I kind of feel like Christina was waiting for Britney to go down so she could rise to the occasion, because there's a clip from 2002, and in this clip you will see she's talking about Britney's breakup, and she's like, Britney should just have a break, and she says it in a kind way, but I also feel like she's being a little bit snarky and trying to tell Britney to stop so that she can, you know, flourish.
Well, I think it's great that Britney's taking a break.
Yeah.
I say,
yeah.
Hell yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Take that break. Go ahead. Shoot.
Is there bad
you
blood?
Were working your ass off.
No,
girl,
it takes
a break.
It's really crazy. What? It's like, I didn't know if you were saying that sarcastically or if you like meant that seriously.
Oh, no. I was like, totally seriously. When you work hard.
Yeah, you need a break.
You know?
So back to 2003, because there was a situation that went down. It all happened at Joseph's Club, which pretty much Justin and Christina were rumored to be hanging out there that night. So Britney wanted to go to that club to confront Justin and pretty much talk about their relationship issues, maybe just hash it out and get back together. Supposedly Britney walked in and she went to the VIP section because, I mean, Britney Spears, and she saw Christina and Justin there getting all close to each other, supposedly, allegedly kissing up on each other. And when she confronted them about this situation, they tried to provide some excuses, you know, we're just long-term friends, it doesn't mean anything, but Britney was officially over it, and I really think at this point Britney was done with Christina. I think she was also done with Justin. Seeing these two worlds collide, it was probably so annoying for her, just because their careers were butting head, their friendship was pretty much over, and now their relationships are colliding. Even though Christina and Justin claimed that nothing happened between them, I do feel like there was probably a little bit of something that definitely hurt Britney. Another scandal that happened that same year was that Christina was supposedly recording her next album. It was going to be her fourth one, and there was a song on the track list that was supposedly written by someone named Aurora Lynn. Well, Aurora Lynn is supposedly a ghost name for Britney Spears. So the situation is, Christina is pretty much recording her fourth album, and she comes across this song that's written by an Aurora Lynn. She doesn't know who Aurora Lynn is, but then once she finds out that it's Britney Spears, she decides to dump the song and scrap it away. This is because she wants nothing to do with Britney. So the Justified and Stripped tour goes on. And this brings us to the VMAs in 2003. And I have a feeling you guys know what I'm about to talk about, because it was the kiss that was seen around the world. Madonna performs with Britney and Christina Aguilera, and at the end of their performance, Madonna goes and kisses Britney Spears, and then afterwards kisses Christina. And it was such a wild moment to see on camera. I actually remember watching it live as a child and just being like, holy crap, what is going on here? But it was so funny when it went down, the cameras actually shot to Justin Timberlake, and his face, he was not happy about it. And honestly, I don't even think Christina was really happy about it, because after this whole thing went down, the media kind of flipped it, and it looks good for Britney and Madonna, but when it it comes to Christina, it made her look bad. I don't know why the media had a different perception of Madonna and Christina kissing. I feel like when they saw that happen, they were like, ew, Christina got, you know, Madonna and Britney's sloppy seconds. And in the long run, it definitely did not play in her favor. There was another VMA award show later on that year in Europe, because, you know, Europe has their own VMAs. And during this award show, there was a moment between Christina and Justin that was extremely shady towards Britney and just crude and gross. Pretty much, they were on stage and Christina has a blow-up plastic, you know, human figure that's supposed to represent Britney Spears, and the way that they're talking about it and just making fun of her is so sick.
So glad. I've been looking for that everywhere.
Yeah, exactly. And the writers thought it looked kind of familiar to some.
That was actually the video I saw that told me to make this video, because I felt like it was really repulsive of Christina to talk about Britney in that way. And they were, you know, dealing with their bad breakup. She was already getting a bunch of heat because of that. And Christina just, you know, doing these little jabs was putting the icing on the cake.
It's a business. They want their magazine sold. And people don't want to read about, you know, somebody they perceived having a perfect life. They want to read the dirt. They want to read the garbage. They want to hear about, you know, rivalries.
Then the Blender interview happened, and honestly, this is when all hell broke loose. It was in 2003, Britney just released her fourth album, In the Zone, which has one of the most iconic pop songs ever, Toxic, which is still a huge hit today. But anyways, there was an interview that Christina did for a magazine titled Blender. During this interview, she was asked about Britney Spears pretty much the same way she's been asked about Britney for the past like 5 years of every interview she's ever done. But in this interview, she decided to turn it up a bit, and she talked about Britney, and she said that when she last saw Britney, that she seemed very distant, even during rehearsals. Every time I tried to start a conversation with her, well, let's just say she seemed nervous the whole time. She seems to me like a lost little girl, someone who desperately needs guidance. The lost little girl comment was really like just off guard, and Britney was not happy about this. She actually kind of addressed the situation on TV, and this is what she had to say.
It's like, you know what? I'm just doing my job. The media, they're the one who make it interpreted it that way.
Yeah.
I'm just doing what I do.
Yeah.
And if they want to interpret it and misconstrue it in their way, let them misconstrue it.
Now,
so.
How do you respond to Christina, though? Because that's kind of like a personal pot shot. Like, that,
you know what?
Right.
I don't want to say anything.
Really?
No. She has an amazing voice. She's an amazing girl, but she says some things sometimes that are just kind of rude. And I don't.
You're seeing class right now, ladies and gentlemen. Very nice.
Britney was obviously really hurt by those comments, because she not only addressed it on TV, but she was later on interviewed and she said, a lost girl. I think it's probably the other way around. I can't believe she said that about me. When someone has been rude to you so many times, it's like, you know what, Christina? I'm really not about the fake anymore. Honestly, period. And that sounds like a very authentic answer. Like, I'm not about the fake. Like, why are you dragging me right now? What is the problem here? And I'm not trying to act like I'm pro Britney, pro Christina. I'm really not pro either. Obviously, I'm pro free Britney. But when it comes to Christina, I don't have any bad taste or bad blood or anything. I'm a fan of them both. And I think they both are iconic in their own way. But this fight between them kept going on, and it was not lightening up. In that same interview, Britney actually shares a story she has about Christina. And it's a very interesting one. She hadn't seen Christina in 2 years when they ran into each other and had a very weird encounter. She comes up to me in a club in front of all these people and she tries to put her tongue down my throat, Spears claimed. I say, it's good to see you. And she goes, well, you're not being real with me. I was like, well, Christina, what's your definition of real? Going up to girls and kissing them after you hadn't seen them for 2 years? So the fight was heating up, and Britney actually talked about this story in an interview and shared what happened.
Christina, not too long ago, and she said that she saw you in a club, and it was when you'd just broken up with Justin.
Did she tell you that she tried to kiss me?
Yes. Is that a CD UK exclusive?
Yes, she did. Yeah, we were at a club and she came to me and she put her tongue down my throat. I was like, hello, I haven't seen you in 2 years. How are you?
She likes you.
Yeah, obviously.
Because in the meantime, she told us that she was giving you advice about the breakup with Justin and stuff.
Oh, she was? Okay.
Got something else going on at the time?
No, I don't remember talking to her about that.
So in 2004, Madonna and Britney actually collaborated on a song, Me Against the Music, and it was an okay hit. It didn't really do that well when it comes to numbers, but it was a moment because Madonna was iconic and Britney was iconic, and they were both collaborating. Christina had some choice words when it comes to describing her thoughts on this collaboration, and she definitely wasn't kind when describing what she thought about the music video and the song.
I wished it was like the same old, you know. It was very bowling pin formation, dancers behind, you know. It was nothing that you haven't seen yet. I was like, oh, you know, that's dope, you know, Britney, Madonna, you know. I was actually hoping for something a little more exciting, you know, but, you know, it was what it was. It was a Paul Hunter video, and that's that.
But Britney had a lot going on in her personal life. Earlier on this year, she actually married Jason Alexander, who she annulled her marriage with 55 hours after getting married. So he's not considered an ex-husband, because when you annul a marriage, it just like completely wipes it out. So she does not have an ex-husband named Jason Alexander, even though so many media outlets love to call him her ex-husband. But that same year, she did get engaged to Kevin Federline. You guys know all about Kevin because he is the father of Britney's children, and he was a backup dancer who turned into her fiance and later on her husband. I have a whole video exposing Kevin Federline and talking about how he has been draining Britney of money for years now. So if you want to check that out, definitely go watch that one, because Kevin is a snake. But Christina was asked about Britney's relationship with Kevin, and when she answered these questions, she went in. It was wild. In an interview, they asked Christina about Britney and Kevin, and she said, I know Britney. She's not trailer trash, but she sure acts that way. Christina was also shading Britney because she was claiming that Britney bought her own engagement ring, the one that Kevin gave to her. And she said, quote, I can't believe that girl bought her own engagement ring. I've seen it up close. It looks like she got it on QVC. Oh my gosh, that is so shady. So obviously not cool, and I'm sure Britney did not appreciate it. I mean, between this interview and the Blender interview, Christina has been going in on Britney. But I do feel like Christina started feeling a little bit guilty because she was ragging on Britney and Britney wasn't really reciprocating it. I mean, of course they shaded each other, but it was usually kind of Christina going at Brit and Brit being like, yeah, you know, I'm not going to comment on that. Well, Christina supposedly wrote Britney a letter, but Britney never responded to her. And Christina went on TV to call out Britney and pretty much say, yo, girl, like, if you want to reply to my message, that would be great.
I wrote her a letter. I just want everybody to know regarding the Blender article. I said I didn't stand behind the article and whatnot, but I've yet to hear back from Miss Britt. So, Brittany, if you hear this, you know, I'd like an answer. I'd like a response.
That takes us to 2005, and Britney actually has her own website at this point where she has been posting letters and little messages to her fan, which was probably really great because before this, she had no direct contact to her fans. The media would post whatever they wanted to, and they would pretty much steer the direction of drama or stories or whatever, and it's been really hard for Christina or Britney to defend themselves when it comes to the media because anything they say could be twisted up and then put into a magazine and people will just read the magazine and believe that. But in 2005, on her own website, she shared a post and said that she would love to be close with Christina again. In fact, Britney recently wrote Christina a letter telling her how happy and beautiful Christina looks lately. At this point, the girls were growing up. They were no longer girls and they were women. They were becoming married, they were having kids. I mean, well, at this point, Christina was actually just getting engaged to her husband, but Britney was already married and she was expecting her first child. So I think that they were kind of growing up and were over the fights that were going on between each other. It wasn't lighthearted anymore and it got pretty nasty. 2005 was kind of a quiet year, so moving on to 2006, Britney was actually pregnant with her second son. Christina was focusing on her music. She was working on her Back to Basics album, which was more of a conservative sound and a little bit more mature for Christina. So Christina was taking it easy. She was focusing on her music, while Britney was really struggling because the media was tearing apart her parenting skills. She was already pregnant with her second kid, and once she gave birth to her kid, 2 months after, she filed for divorce against Kevin. So there was a lot of drama going on in Britney's life, but it seems like the drama between her and Christina was lightening up because that same year, Christina and Britney exchanged gifts because Christina was getting married, Britney just gave birth to her second child, and here's a little clip of Christina describing what went down.
And we understand that you all exchanged wedding gifts.
Beautiful. Yeah, absolutely. We keep a relationship and, you know, just hearing each other, I mean, God, what an amazing thing. We've grown up together in this business, basically. So we're all doing amazing things, mm-hmm. and, you know, becoming mommies and, you know, husbands and wives. It's, yeah. You know, crazy. So it's a beautiful time in all of our lives.
In 2007, things got a lot darker for Britney Spears. She released her album Blackout, which did pretty well, but songs like Piece of Me described how the media was tearing her apart and she wasn't happy about it. She had her breakdown during this time where she shaved her head and was going through it, and there was no one there to support her. No one in her life, no friends she can trust, and she was absolutely alone out here in the world battling the paparazzi trying to survive. In January 2008, Christina gives birth to her first child. That following month, February, Britney was put into a conservatorship, and all of her rights were taken away and given to her father. Since then, she has been trapped in a conservatorship, and even though she did some work during this time and put out a couple of albums, she hasn't been doing anything for herself. She has been working for a business manager who does not care about her finances, and her father, who has issues with alcohol, controls her every move. That same year, Christina did an interview with the Daily Mail, and she talked about her relationship with Britney. She actually spoke quite fondly of Britney and said, "When we both started releasing records, it was a funny time for me. It must have seemed as if we were competing with each other. But in reality, Britney is someone that I used to hold hands with. We were silly little girls together on the Mickey Mouse Club. What a journey it has been for both of us." So at this point in 2008, they are both very separate from each other. But later on in 2010, Christina was asked about Britney and this dark time that she went through. And Christina shares that she actually wrote Britney during this time, and they seem to go back and forth for quite a bit.
"We had a history together, so it was really cool actually that we were... And so ironic that we were released at the same time."
"Yeah, I know. What did you think when she went through that weird phase?
Did you feel like you should ring her?"
I did, actually. I wrote her a letter and we sort of went back and forth. But, you know, no judgment ever on anyone.
Mm.
Okay. Yeah, that's true. Yeah. And, you know, everyone goes through different things at different stages. Have you ever thought,
everybody
oh my
has
God.
Their own stuff going on.
So maybe at this point they made up, and during these letters, they were writing to each other in a supportive and friendly way. But I also don't understand how Britney was able to be in contact with Christina. I mean, obviously they wrote letters and that's what she says, but also Britney was in a conservatorship. So was her father like reviewing the letters? Like what were they reviewed before they were sent out? I mean, I don't even know how that would go down. But at the end of the day, I don't know how much of a feud this truly was. I mean, I definitely believe that they took jabs at each other and there was definitely some beef, but how much of it was truly beef between them? I mean, I definitely feel like the media had a firestorm with this, and they were able to create a ton of stories by putting these two against each other and creating a competition when there really wasn't one. Christina actually did an interview with Jimmy Kimmel, and during this interview, they talk a little bit about social media and the impacts of social media. Christina said that she was initially skeptical of social media and the vain selfie culture until she realized that these platforms gave her power over her own narrative. "Back then, in the 90s, the media was the storyteller for you," she said. "When I was coming up, it was very obvious me and Britney were definitely considered rivals. If we had social media back then, we probably would have done a song together or something and squashed it." And honestly, that is such a powerful thing because social media does give these artists the power again because they can call out fake stories. They can call out the media lies and the manipulation of it all. And actually, not that long ago, within the last year, Christina actually shared a picture of Britney Spears along with a collage of inspirational women, and she tagged her in this. And I do feel like Britney and Christina have a special relationship because they were just young girls in 1993 on the Mickey Mouse Club, and they were definitely friends then. They spent hours and hours together. And even though they got older and they had some competition and there were sales and music and a ton of things involved, I do think down deep in their hearts, they do care for each other. At least I feel like maybe Christina does care about Britney, because I feel like Britney has put up a barrier or a wall against everyone just because of how she's been screwed over so many times. But from what I've seen Christina say since that time has been kind when it comes to Britney. So I wouldn't be surprised if she's pro-free Britney, to be honest. I mean, she knows firsthand how it feels to be controlled by someone you do not like. Remember her manager, Steven, she fired very early on in her career. I mean, that's nothing compared to a conservatorship, but I'm sure that Christina could relate in that way. So what do you guys think about this feud? I definitely feel like there was beef. We cannot deny that there was some fighting, there were some shady things said, but do you feel like the media really just took this and ran with it? Because that's what I'm thinking. It was the perfect storm. We had the media who was so hungry to tear everyone down, and we had two friends who they could take their relationship and pit them against each other so that they can have some stories and some magazine covers to sell. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Definitely comment below what you think. And if you have any video ideas for me, 2000s tea, before that, I mean, new things, any ideas, feel free to email me, and my email is listed below. So I have a couple of P.O. Box items I'm going to open for you guys today. So let's go ahead and open it. This is actually from someone named Hoshi, and it looks like they are in the United States. So let's go ahead and see what they have to say. Oh, guys. Oh my gosh. I have been, waiting to film this video for so long, ever since my Justin Timberlake video, and I'm so happy to finally have it done. I mean, the research for this alone was pretty crazy because there are so many clips from back in the day, but it was really cool to see just how the media was just crazy manipulative. I mean, with hindsight now. So it looks like, oh, what's this? Is this a little note? It looks like it's a very little note inside here, which is perfectly fine. Hey Sloan, here is a special discount code for my sticker shop. Feel free to share it with your subscribers. The code is Sloan. Oh, that's awesome. I'll list it below so you guys can go and shop. And it looks like they have some stickers here. So let's go ahead and see what is in here. Oh, that's so awesome that they gave me a code. I'm like, every time when packages give me a code, I'm like, whoa, okay. Like, I feel special now. So you guys can use my code Sloan for some percentage off. And here are some, of those. Oh, Hoshikuma. I think that's what you say, right? Hoshikuma. And here are some of those. Oh my gosh, these are awesome. Some of these stickers. These are like so cool. They kind of look like, is it anime? Anime? I feel like kind of like Japanese, like cartoony kind of characters, which is so cute. Here are some, oh gosh, these are some animals I don't like here. The FROGs, we will give those away to someone who wants those, but these are so cute. Oh my gosh, this is by far my favorite. It's like a dog burger. What is going on here? I love it. Thank you so much, Hoshi. This is awesome. And oh, Yoshi right here. Thank you so much for speaking out against Dan Schneider. I hope one day he gets what he deserves. I love your videos. Keep up the great work. Thank you so much. And I will list everything below. So definitely go check them out and check out their stickers. You guys can use my code Sloan. But I want to open one more package just because I've got some piling up. And this one actually says free Amanda, free Britney. So I was like, oh, it's Britney related. So let's go ahead and open this one for you guys. It's from Stitch Normal, and let's go ahead and see what's going on in here. It's packaged in like some very white, thick paper, and it's packaged really well, so I'm interested to see what's going on here. Oh my gosh, I'm kind of nervous. Just a random box. I did not send... Oh, okay, okay, cool. I was like, what is the random box? It's like little... It's metal pegboard hooks. Oh, cool. So it's very random, but unrelated. So let's see what is in here. I need my sword. I always pick it up and then I put it down and I can't find it again. Okay, here we go. Ooh, I'm so excited. Okay, so let's... Don't have a lot of room here. Okay, here is the note. So let's go ahead and see who this is from. Sloan, I hope you and your family are doing well. The gifts I'm sending you are not items that I sell. They are a hat that I made and a few... burn bundles of kitchen sage and lavender. Oh, that's so awesome. I have watched all of your videos since just after the beginning of the lockdown last year. Wow, that's a long time. Yours is the only tea channel that I am subscribed to. Oh, it's so sweet. And I love the vlogs. Oh, I used to do vlogs back in the day. Tell me, oh my gosh, the Thanksgiving. Wow, you really do watch all the vlogs. I love that. Since you're always so kind and helping person, I was hoping you could spread the word about my podcast. It's for survivors of childhood trauma. On my podcast, I offer a safe space for survivors to speak anonymously. Oh, that's awesome. I will definitely list this below because that is incredible. Her podcast or his podcast. Actually, I'm not too sure because the name is Stitch, and I guess that's kind of gender neutral, so we'll say they. Their podcast is Navigating Normal. You can find it on Spotify, and hopefully it will be on other platforms soon. Oh, that's awesome. Thank you so much for your time and everything that you do to spread awareness. Thank you. And I will link your podcast below. You guys should definitely go check it out, and I will be definitely checking it out and listening to it and subscribing because that helps them. And here's a hat that they made. This is so cute. Hold up. Look how cute this. I gotta smell it first, make sure there's no, like, chemicals on it. Look at that. Oh, such a vibe. Such a vibe, Stitch. Thank you. That is so cool. And then... let's see what this thing is. Kind of scary. Oh my gosh. They already told me that it was a bundle. Did you see my face? I definitely went like that. But here is... oh, wow. These are like some... oh my gosh. Smells so good. Some sage bundles. Some lavender bundles. Wow, that's really awesome. And it will be great to burn in my place. So thank you so much, Stitch. I really appreciate it. And thank you guys for watching this video. I will see you guys in a new one soon. Bye, guys.